Sun, sand and sea, classic ingredients for beach volleyball. Here in the Netherlands, it's a case of two out of three ain't bad. Plenty of sand and plenty of sea as the Swatch World Tour reaches its climax right here in The Hague. Welcome to Centre Court here in The Hague. Clayton Lucas with you for the men's bronze medal match as Russia's Koshkarev and Semenov take on Benes and Kubala from the Czech Republic. First glimpse of Semenov for Russia and Koshkarev, his compatriot. Koshkarev will be doing the defending, but Semenov at 2.08 will be doing the blocking. It's mostly cloudy. The rain has stayed away today, and we are happy for that. And as far as the wind's concerned, it's just picked up a little bit, 7.5 miles per second. But it does mean that it makes for a very interesting game out on centre court. The wind blowing from the backs of the Russians. As we have our quick look at Primozil Kubala, 37 years of age. Not likely to be doing a great deal of hitting today, but he's the blocker and the player that will be setting up this man, Petr Benes. He's here to be tasked with doing most of the siding out for the Czech Republic if Russia go to form and play them the way that most other teams do. Slav Koshkarev at 26, still a youngster, but his playing partner is even younger at 22. Koshkarev does the defending, and he's the guiding force in this partnership. And Semenov, still a youngster, 22 years of age, 2.08, but teams still have been going after him inside out. He's not perhaps as strong as he needs to be at the moment, still learning his trade on the World Tour, and still prone to making the odd mistake.
Beach Volleyball Swatch World Tour.
Well, when that's finished, the players now getting ready to be introduced to the sand. Not sure how much of those knee straps are for Petr Benes, but once the sand gets in them, they'll become very, very itchy. First referee from Brazil, Luiz Oliveira, he's in charge. And down on the sand, AB assisting from Norway, is Stuart Hardison. So Brimsel Kubala out onto court for the Czech Republic to take his applause, followed by his playing partner Petr Benes. Two veterans of the game who come from the indoors onto the beach. For Russia, two young stars in the form of Koshkarev and Semenov. So the final exchange of pleasantries is over. A chance for one team to make the podium and for their best ever finish on the World Tour. First set about to get underway. Czech Republic playing in white. It's Petr Benes with the serve. Russia in red receiving. Koshkarev. Oh, just fluffed his lines there. Almost caught the line as well. A few nerves on display. Semenov will serve now for Russia. He'll come through to the net and block. nice pickup from Koshkarev. Can he finish it off? Yes, he can. Lovely play from him. Ben is stuck in at the net, and he's not really the blocker in the partnership for the Czech Republic. And his lack of height is exposed by Koshkarev as he goes over the line. Semenov still learning his trade. He didn't really look at that one. He got his hands across the net, but he wasn't looking at the ball. He was looking at his feet, if anything. And I have no idea where they'd gone. Must keep your eyes on the ball at all times. But from the end of Czech Republic, they're going to really have to batter the ball in order to get it over the net. This time got a little bit tucked up by the pass from Kubala. Let's have a look at this again. He suddenly finds himself trying to have to cut across his body and he ran out of court. This time he gets it right. Pretty much going underneath 7-0. So he's not really active with his hands in at the net at the moment. That will come with time. That's off the block now. And that's a play the Czech Republic like to run. Fast ball out wide. Nice break from Kubala, and he finishes it off really well. The pick up from the Czech Republic. Semenov was all over that. We were disappointed that he hadn't finished the rally off with his block. Another good block, and he makes another one, but not really strong enough to see that go straight down. Benes was lurking, got all in play, and Kubala did the rest. Looking to go off the block, and out was Koshkarev. But he didn't find the hands of Kubala. That one by a long way. Kubala with the serve. Czech Republic have turned things around in their favour now, leading by one. It's another one that goes out, and it's another one that doesn't touch. Kubala on its way out. And usually very reliable Koshkarev with two unforced errors in a row. Over the top of Kubala, and that's hit Peter Benes right in the face. Semenov didn't mean to do it. That's the risk you take when you defend him. Just look how high Semenov goes here. And Peter Benes, well, what is he doing? He's still wondering what day of the week it is, I think. Okay, another look at this again. It's just he's off and running, but he had no idea where that ball was going, and it's caught him by surprise, and he's got himself a stinger. Well, he was lucky for Philip Benners, it was only Semmer not putting the ball at him. It would have been Allison for Dalhouser. And he would have been serious trouble. But it's Semmer not to serve for Russia. Czech Republic leading by one. Semenov making it difficult for Pelomenes, trying to guide it over him. In so doing, he misses the line. Good pick up. Excellent play from Koshkarev. Semenov was trying to make it a little bit difficult for Kubala at the net, which he did, gave Koshkarev the chance to go again. Well, that is Will Field here, who's impeded at the net, was he? Certainly, I think it was more a case of Benners going into Semenov, if anything, and he just couldn't get himself back in to play the ball. And he's travelled in, down he goes. He's trying to avoid going into and hitting Semenov. You do have to play the ball quite low and close together in these conditions. The Czech Republic like to do that. Oh, what a block that is from Semenov. He came running in and going off with 1 foot. He did so well to get his hands over the net and not actually touch it. Make a good high jumper, wouldn't he? This time though, he can't get there quickly enough. Nice play from the Czech Republic. They're fighting hard here in this first set. And is off and running, keeps his eye on the ball, and comes up with a nice cross-court roll. So we're into the technical timeout. It's Russia leading by three. Pelomenes is in the wars. Take required for Kubala.
FIVB, Beach Volleyball Swatch World Tour.
Well, tape on his left hand, that's keeping one finger taped to the other. He's got a bit of an injury there. Similar story with his other hand. So, interesting blocking call from Semenov. He's going line against Kubala. I think he's just going at the ball against Pelomenes. There for Koshkarev to play, he knows it. He went half the distance, couldn't all the way. You do have to force yourself at times. It's too easy to give up. swing. Easy cross-court cut for Kubalek. Semenov moved across, but it was taking away the line and nobody was stopping cross-court. Nice block to start with, but he's nowhere near this one. Russia are trading points nicely. They're keeping the scoreboard ticking over and they're keeping their noses in front. Nice powerful hit from Koshkin. It's now a 4-point lead for Russia. Good pick up and a good follow through to get the point. Siding out, okay. They're just not really getting anything going from their serve at the moment, their block defence. Well, that will do nicely. I'd say the block defence isn't getting any points. But the serve's just done it for him. Bit of luck for Kubalek, and he'll take it. Once again, going right over the top of Kubalek. He was at the top floor. Semenov was up in the Pentax. Watch it go over the top here. Kubalek can't get anywhere near him. And it almost becomes impossible for Bennett. That'll do nicely for the Czech Republic. But they still need to make inroads into this deficit. Decided breaking was the best option. Koshkov said, thank you very much. I can hit it hard from the meter, 2 metres or even 3 metres off the net. Doesn't matter to him. He gets himself an easy swing and a very good pull away. Now Koshkov turned by the ball. Plenty of power display from both teams. Now Koshkov got in front of Semenov, and Semenov then couldn't get round him to go after the ball. Semenov not moving his feet. Oh, he made that look so easy. Kubalek with a jump serve. Koshkov with a decent pass and then an excellent put away. Pettibenis is getting stuck mid-court behind the block. He really needs to commit to a position, either left or right. Nice work. The reason you don't want to be stuck mid-court in the centre is that means you've got to run left and right. Whereas really, in defence, you only want to be running one way. You want to stand in one position, cross-court or line, so that the ball is going to either be hit hard at you and you chase down a roll shot. don't want to be stuck having to chase down left and right. Oh, nice work. Give a little jump in. Marks it into the cross court. And up he goes. Shows the guns. Reaching right in to shut out Koshkov. This time Koshkov gets the better of the block. Koshkov with the serve. Excellent blocking. It was always drifting towards Semenov. Venice couldn't do anything about it. It's now set point for Russia. Koshkov's going to batter this one. He does, and it's not coming back, and at the first time of asking Russia to take the set, 21-18, they have one foot on the podium.
In his bronze medal match.
Great serve from Koshkov. He knew it was a great opportunity for him to really go hard at the ball. He's done that, and he's beaten Petr Benes to his left. And Russia have the first set in the bag. So Russia have chosen to receive for the start of the second set. A little bit of rain, but that won't dampen the spirits. Here are the highlights from the first set. Two about to get underway. Czech Republic is serving. Russia receiving, having taken the first set. It'll be Benes with the ball. Definitely Semenov's to play. He made the touch, he turned around, he saw Koshkov moving. And that's because Koshkov's the dominant player in the partnership. And instead of taking control of the situation, Semenov's waiting for instruction instead of going after this one. He's best placed to play it to give Koshkov the chance to have a swing because Koshkov's facing the net and Semenov isn't. Nice work from Koshkov. Lovely pass, and then that's a great line shot. But he can't back it up from the serving line. A tricky one, great touch by Kibler, and then he decided to go and chase that one down. Probably, in this occasion, Benes was best placed to have it, and probably would have got it as well. Sometimes you just don't get the luck. Seven up to serve. Oh, brilliant block. 7 August there, ready and waiting. And when he's 2 metres and 8 and the net's 2.43, he doesn't have to jump that high. When he stands there with his hands up, they're already above the net. And then they went straight across the net and the ball went straight down. Line block sets being signalled, he wants the ball down the middle. This is a very good start for Russia in this second set. And now the 2-point lead, two blocks in a row from Semenov, the difference. Another touch in the block by Semenov, but a weak one, and Koshkarev not quick enough to get the ball back into play. In fact, Koshkarev not even looking at the ball. Really important you do, it's not indoor, and it's on the beach, you've got to see what's going on, there's only two of you there. Is even when he's out of position, he really commits to the spike. And that is what plays dividends for him here. Oh, nearly spectacular. Looks like someone else banged his head here. Or tricked his neck by the looks of it. As he's gone down, he's just giving himself a bit of whiplash. He's okay, he's just getting the sand out of his eyes. And then he'll be fit to continue. Good disguise from Koshkarev on that play. This time Benes attacks it, gets a little bit of space to work with and exploits it well. Just waited, biding his time. It was the deftest of touches, certainly good enough to get the Czech Republic the point. Benes wasn't sure though, he was still up and running to see whether this one was going to come down on their side. Oh, good pick up, great play. Chance here for Russia. And maybe another one. Net touch, was it? No, play on. That's a great rally, and it's the Czech Republic who have the point. Benes saw that one moment that Koshkarev may have touched the bottom of the net as he played the ball off of it, but that's a brilliant pick-up. They battled hard, and they got their reward. Very compact player, good technique in the air, over the holder's position well, good strong core stability, get that one away cross court. just too close to 7-0. It's Russia's turn to get themselves an ace, courtesy of the net. They can't legislate for it. It's just one of those things that happens now. The ball allowed to touch the net, as long as it goes in play. As well, as long as you don't impede the other player, which is what Petr Bennis does here. He carries on through, he's fine, he's gone to the net, and he's too low, able to get it off the block and out. That's another one. Bennis again getting stuck mid-court, but he's just asking for trouble, really. He's getting caught behind Kubala's block, and that's not the right place to be. Koshkov now with a chance to finish this rally off. No block, but he's overhit it. Just tried too hard. Cross court block. Kubala wants Petr Bennis to sit line. Block can't stop the cross court effort from Koshkarev. That's a great swing. He really gives this everything. Technical timeout. It's Russia. We have a slender lead and not one set in the bag already. Here are the highlights from the set so far. Step back out onto the sand, ready to go again. It's a must-win set for the Czech Republic. They're definitely in this set, they're just one behind. Russia playing well, Czech Republic scrambling well. Oh, that's a great serve. Now on court, Koshkarev by surprise. Probably was going out, it hit him very high, and he was quite close to that baseline. He just couldn't get out of the way. It was going right. Another chance here. Semenov decides to go over 1-2. A little bit of luck. Bennis again throwing himself at the ball. And his reaction's good enough to see it go back over the net and land in court. Kubala was there, it just didn't press strongly enough at the net. It was a very quick case of, no, you see my hands, no you don't. Instead of actually staying there and forcing them across the net for a longer period. Koskarev knows where Benes is going to go across court, and he knows where he should have been stood. That's a top swing from Koskarev. He is flying out of this sand. From Pedro Benes, he misses the block, he doesn't find the court. And Russia stay in front. It's another lucky ace for Russia, they don't care how they get them, they're just glad to have them. Frustration for the Czech Republic. Semenov again, just too narrow in his block. You see his hands, his thumbs, pretty much touching each other when he goes to block, instead of reaching out onto the ball. We got given a line call at Semenov and he listened to it and put it away. Koskarev shouting Linya and Semenov obliging. Well, Russia won't be too bothered as long as they can keep siding out as well and having a 2-point lead every time they do get the side out puts them in a good position to get to the business end of this set. It was a change of mind midway through his swing, Koskarev. Was looking like going cross court, tried to change it to a line shot. And it cost him. This time he sticks with the cross court angle and it pays dividends. Too happy. I think he's hurt something. I'm not sure whether it's a knee or a hand or what. But he's not happy. Deep, deep breaths, I think, required for Pedro Benes. I think he might just have caught himself in the round tables, you know. I think as he comes through to play this, he's all right there, but just watch what happens with his hands as he comes down. I think the less said the better about that. I think he's going to be all right. A few deep breaths, he'll be fine. He got the point. And Czech Republic at the ball. could have tried to get out of the eye line of Koshkov by getting down very low and then trying to come up into Koshkov's view very late, but it was too late. Dennis is coming up with the points. He's fighting hard for his team. And they're keeping it very close. Big side out required now for Russia. Nice pick up from Dennis. And a great put away, is it? No, it's just missed on the sideline. He can't believe it. The ball seemed to stay in the air for an age. I think everything just went into slow motion for him as he watched it go over and hit the sand at the wrong side of the line. So unlucky. And the Czech Republic call a timeout. Well, it all comes down to this, the Czech Republic, they need their side out to send it to 19-all. They've got to try and get a point from the serving line to give them a set point. Otherwise, if the Czech Republic don't do that, and if Russia side out, they'll have a match point opportunity. Can't pick beyond the next play though, and you have to just think about what's in front of you. They need it. Russia need a big set smash, need a side out. Czech Republic need a point themselves. What's Koshkov going to do here? He's battered a few serves from the serving line that end. He goes for another hard one. Well passed by Benes. And well put away by him as well. And it's the Czech Republic who bring themselves level. But the situation remains the same. Russia side out. And they'll have a match point chance. Kubala. Benes is in the right place. Can he finish it off? No, he can't. It's a massive block from Semenov. And it's now a match point opportunity for Russia. This time he makes a spread block and it pays off. It'll be Semenov with the serve. He's going to keep it in play, come through to block. And after Benes again. Koshkov keeps it in play, but it's going to be the Czech Republic who have the opportunity to get the point. Koshkov for the match. And he's done it. It's bronze for Russia. It's their biggest win on the tour, and that's what it means to them. I think they're going to be celebrating long into the night. Their first ever podium, it's a bronze for Russia. It's a fourth place finish for the Czech Republic. It's a massive result for Russia. They'll be delighted. These young guns have come up trumps in the Hague. And this is how it was done. Semenov comes through. Forces Benes into the roll shot. Great effort from Koshkov. Keeps it in play. And then Russia reset their block defense once again. There's another shot from Benes that doesn't find the sand. And Koshkov goes in, goes at it. And Benes can't keep it in play. And just watch Semenov. When this ball goes down, watch the youngster as he goes down as well. What a celebration from Koshkarev. Happy days for Russia. They're going to go and get themselves nice and warm, get ready for their medal presentations, which will happen later on today. It's the end of the road for the Czech Republic. Unfortunately for them, they didn't find themselves on the podium. Here are the highlights from the match. Still two more matches to be decided here at The Hague. At 2.30 CET, we'll have the gold medal match from the women's event, and at 1600 CET, it will be the men's gold medal match. But until then, it's time for me to say goodbye. We'll see you again soon.